Pollinators are the animals that help plants get pollen from one plant to another. So this is a really important process for plants. It's required for them to reproduce and continue surviving. Butterflies and bees are the main ones that we think about, but wasps, beetles, bats even in some places are also pollinators. There are lots of small mammals and other insects besides bees and butterflies.
The Alabama Power Shoreline Recreation Team is taking open areas at our preserve locations and converting them into pollinator-friendly plots.
Josh Yerby and myself started working together on some of the plant species and, you know, soil testing and all the things that needed to be done before these wildflower meadows could be established. And it's been a great partnership. Alabama Power has done some wonderful things at these parks, and I was just really happy to be a part of it.
One of the great things about the seed mix that we use is that it is all native plant species to our area.
Native plants are plants that are found here naturally. They were not introduced by people, and they don't require as much herbicide, pesticide sort of stuff versus a non-native that you introduce. You know, it takes more water, it takes more managing. It can get out of hand and take over and out-compete the native plants and not actually help your pollinators.
There's many reasons why pollinator populations may be on the decline. It could be habitat destruction. It could be overuse or misuse of pesticides and just lack of food crops for our pollinator species.
Our pollinators hibernate over winter in leaf litter or underground or in various areas like that. And when they emerge in early spring, they need a food source, a nectar source. One really great weed, if you will, that blooms is our dandelion and then our clovers. So one small step you can take to help pollinators is just to not mow early.
That's a big thing when people are saying, you know, leave the leaf litter over the winter, or no mow May. You know, all these things are helping because it gives them that early nectar and pollen in the spring and provides places for them to live through the winter.
Without pollinators, 30% of everything we ate would not be pollinated, and we wouldn't be able to eat those foods. And then we can go even further and think about the goods that we get from those plants, such as textiles or wood to make our houses. So there are a lot of things to think about, you know, when we're thinking about preserving pollinators.
Without pollinators, very simply put, we would not survive. You know, so you think about the food chain and you think about the bees that pollinate and then the bigger animals that eat the bees. It works its way all the way up, whether it's through that process or directly losing our food crops, we would be in trouble.
The main goal for me as an extension agent is to save the farmers. That's really where we make our difference. And of course, along the way, we save the bees. But it's really about knowing where your food comes from, knowing how it was grown, and educating the farmers how to plant and spray pesticides appropriately.
Everybody has a part when it comes to preserving our pollinators. You know, and this starts in everybody's backyard. Gardening is by far the number one hobby in the United States. So that gives us all a chance, you know, to work with our pollinators, making sure they have habitat, planting the right plants in the right place for those pollinators, as well as monitoring our pesticide use.
Just making those small choices, you know, when spring comes around and you get that bug to plant something, choose a native.
You know, I think public knowledge about pollinators would be a start. What is pollinator habitat? What are pollinators? And, you know, and then more knowledge about how we can, you know, help pollinators out by, you know, creating more habitat like we're doing here.
Just think about providing things that the pollinators want, even a simple water dish with some rocks in it that they can stop and have a quick drink in and not drown in. Just small things like that.